Good morning and welcome back to an exciting game of basketball today. We have Bedford, our home team, playing against Bethlehem, which is a local Saskatoon team. As we scored, which is not awesome for Bedford, but awesome for them.
Bedford, fun fact, has not made it out of the consolation bracket since 2004 at our own tournament.
Wow. That's not good.
No, it's really not.
I think we have maybe, I don't know, it's a high caliber tournament.
It is.
The fact that we're on it, we should just be proud.
We don't get disinvited from our own home school.
Yes, that would be painful. All right, Caleb Dover. Just a side note about Caleb. His uncle lives in Trinidad and Tobago and has been online watching us.
Yeah, a couple of games. I've seen it.
Uh-huh. It's pretty awesome. All right, Bethlehem taking up the court. Sorry, it is early.
There's a reason it's known as the Red Eye game.
Yes. Yes. Last night, around midnight, settling at home.
Yeah, that's about when we finished last night.
Caleb Dover taking it up the court. Over to Hendry. Unfortunately, did not make it.
Other Hendry picks up the rebound, though.
No, I think all Bedford needs is like a basket, and then they'll be good to go. You know, like
just get the momentum,
the
energy,
like dust off, and you know, you just get that. We got something.
That's okay. Watch this. Watch what's about to happen.
Okay.
Open three, uncontested.
Oh, Hendry. So close. So close.
I may have spoke too soon.
Maybe. But basketball is unpredictable. I've learned that in the last day.
There he is.
All right, number two on top of the 3-point. Oh, number six, Patia. Shy, but rebounded by number 11.
Sam Baisong.
You know, I've said his name a lot this last 3 days.
He's a powerful player. He's always getting his name called out. Shots with that, drives like that.
Yeah, well, that's why.
How can you not talk about him? Yeah.
Really, dude. And it's unfortunate he's in grade 12, so he'll be... Okay, this is last Brit?
It's true. This is Beth's first Brit as well. So Sam was a one-shot wonder.
And now he's going down the court again.
Woo, behind the back. Kicks it out.
Oh, number three.
That's a billow.
Rebounded by R. Ann Mulgill.
One of the twin sets that we have.
Yes. I don't know what was in the water that year, but we have... And honestly, they're both on the basketball team. How cool is that?
Yeah.
All right, big one for number 10.
Patia Tombay with a dunk at officially 8.05 a.m. And he draws the foul.
He does draw the foul. We're going to be on with the cameras today because I'm feeling this is the day.
You also are forgetful. I was terrible yesterday. I'd miss like the first one and then the second one and go, oops.
I totally remembered. But, you know, other announcers have their, like, they don't want to spoil the crowd. So. Shot did not go in, but rebounded by Bedford. So, that's a Gill taking it up the court.
The other Gill, by the way.
Yes,
that's Armand, his twin and Mal standing there.
Yeah. The twins, both sets of twins are on the court. So if you think you have double vision. Oh, that's Jet.
That's
Jet, actually.
Yeah.
Jet looks like a Hendry too.
Tall and lanky. Yep. Yeah. Looks pretty much the same.
Yeah. Especially from back here. All right. Admiral likes the three-pointers.
Yeah, he's always been a shooter.
Yeah, he's always key on those. And, you know, there he goes.
By his way, got the green light from coach. Just can't drive away with that.
No. I'm wondering how long till Coach Faye calls a timeout, you know?
I'm wondering how long till Coach Faye starts getting loud.
Oh, yes.
I don't think he really believes in timeouts. He just tells his player while they're still playing in a much more aggressive tone.
He uses volume on his side.
It works. As a teacher, he's learned sometimes that's what they need.
All right, driving in. It's 10-0 for Bethlehem if you're just tuning in with your nice cup of hot coffee, which I left at home today on my counter.
There's Hendry. That's Grayson.
I'm just shy. I know. The boys seem tired. Like we've seen them play.
Oh, yes.
Normally. They just seem tired today. Beth is here to... Sam.
There he is. Bass singing the day away. Look at him go.
Admiral over to his brother.
That's Tirth Patel, actually.
Oh, that's Tirth. You know.
No, that's not. I read the name list wrong.
No, it is.
That is Armand Gill.
Okay. I'm like, you know, I might need new glasses, but today's not a good start. All right. What is happening? Oh, thrown in from the baseline.
Bedford running a stack formation here. They split up.
Oh, man. It just gets so close.
There's Tirth Patel. He was on the court.
Yes.
I was close, at least.
Almost. Mr. Faye is pacing now. But he's got some really good kicks on. Like, that.
Matching set by the Bedford coaching staff.
Yeah, like, they are set. And two of them look like a mini-me of the other one.
It's true.
All right, rebounded by Jet. He's awesome, just as a human being.
He is.
We got inside, outside. And not up. Oh, Bethlehem to shut him down. Oh, no.
Side arm far. Tombe.
Oh. We're.
That'll be an over and back.
Yeah.
Or possibly out of bounds. Out of bounds for that.
Or both. Could it be both? Is it go with what happens first?
What happens first, yeah. Whether Baesong manages to get a finger on it at that point, it would be called an over and back. Which I didn't know last year. I did have to learn that while up in the commentary booth.
I knew, well, I coached basketball, so I knew the rules, but I don't know, for some reason, which order things get called in. All right, they're passing, Bedford's passing it around. G's going in. Oh, Jet's already there, up to Tirth. Oh, that wasn't Tirth.
That's Armand, yeah.
That's Armand. They got new haircuts. I can't keep them separate. Like, they're rocking new styles for Brit. It's awesome, but it's not every day what I'm used to seeing them in.
No, it's not.
It's always good to have good hair. All right. G's throwing it in.
Guillermo to Armand. Can't quite sink the buzzer beater.
No, but he hustled down to the other end.
Who is that? Josh Paris. Looking like a pretty tall guy there. Here he comes.
Oh. And swoosh. Nothing but net. Nice three-pointer.
By Tai Otsuka there, number 12 for Stars. 15-0 unanswered in this first quarter.
You know, I'm just waiting for Bedford's first basket.
Like, we're all waiting.
I think I'd be over-enthusiastic now because I just, you know.
We need something.
Such good guys. I know all of them, so they're such good guys. Not that Bethlehem's not.
Yeah.
But, you know, you just want them to get one.
Here's G.
No. Like, they're just.
They're so close. They're right
so
there.
That's the frustrating part. They're not air balls. They're so close. All right.
There's Leanne Gonzalez. Open three.
Oh. Back up to the top of the three. We'll see what Bethlehem does with it.
Sends it off to a starter, Franco Billo.
Yeah. He's been on fire this week.
Yeah.
All right. If you're just tuning in, Bethlehem is 18. Bedford has a zero, and we have just a minute left in the first quarter.
G called on a travel there. So Baesong's going to inbound it there, and Beth gets possession.
But we have a timeout first. So as we go into a timeout, we want to thank our sponsors for the tournament that are awesome, like Breck Construction and Ham Construction. It's nice when they build things.
I love it.
I've had students employed by them, so they're awesome to me. Anyone that employs our students are great. We also have Old Dutch Chips. I went home craving chips yesterday.
Fair enough.
I think I've been branded now that I'm here.
Yeah, you're an adult. You can just go and buy them. You have money.
I sometimes do, but I.
Yeah,
I think
yeah.
It was so cold last night. Their car said nope.
No, my car did manage to stay at Bedford all last night. Had to call my dad to come pick me up. Oh, yeah. Fully dead. It's still in the parking lot.
Man, did you you bring a cord and plug it
in? I did. I brought an extension cord. I am ready for it, fans.
Okay, yeah, that happens.
If you hear me tomorrow morning, after Brit is all done, someone please call for help.
All right. Let's see what Coach Faye said. That'll inspire our boys.
Yeah, hoping to make some changes.
Yeah. Like, I've been there with when I was a coach, and, like, you're just frustrated, but they're just missing everything by, like, a centimeter.
Yeah, there's not something you can really say to get them to
no.
actually put it in the basket.
No. Wouldn't that be fun, though?
That would be awesome. All right, G, you're going to stop missing from now on.
We have a water bottle down.
Airstrike.
We're okay, though. We're okay.
What's that?
All right. We are now seeing... Oh!
That's a neat occurrence.
Charles Pouche, who is a card just as a human being, the fact that he got subbed in and now got the ball stuck, a game ball. Like, that's his personality through and through.
I think we might have to call... Oh, no.
Nope.
Yes.
Floor crew. Floor crew's there for us.
Our heroes of the morning.
Yes.
See, I would have just sent Sam baseball guard and said, all right, Sam, you're going to grab that and then just finish it off with a dunk.
Oh.
Because the way he plays, he probably could.
That, yeah. Well, was Sam, I can't remember the dunk competition. I just wanted to say Sam was in it, but.
It's possible.
You know, that was like a month ago in my brain right now. Oh, driving in for a layup. Oh.
Draws the foul.
Nice work. He gets the knowledge of knowing he was fouled on.
See, I thought it was going to be shots, and I was totally incorrect.
They're still not in bonus, so once they hit bonus, then we get shots. All right, it's been a pretty clean game so far.
Yeah, three fouls total.
Yeah, and
number 13, Jed Carbonell with a buzzer beater three.
With the buzzer, that is impressive. I like the buzzer shot.
It is. It's always fun.
Fantastic to make.
Were you here yesterday when the Raymond Comets made a shot from their own three-point line?
Yes.
That was outstanding.
That was off the hook. I was, like, screaming in the mic. I had to apologize. It was so awesome.
Even he looked surprised. That yeah. He just looked at his team like, did it? Was that me?
It was pretty epic. If I was his parents, I'd be, like, clipping that section
that
of
photo scene, yes.
or video of. All right. Some of our other sponsors are Trail Appliances. When you own your own house, I found out that you need to buy appliances when they break because you don't like doing dishes anymore.
Words of wisdom.
Yeah, so they're awesome. And they're in the north end of Saskatoon, right, actually located, same parking lot as the Rattlers, who are also a sponsor.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
Rattlers and Huskies, I see.
Yep.
Sponsoring Brad Redekop, MLA
yes.
for Saskatoon West.
Or MLA.
I'm wondering if we'll see him come tonight. I know he's come for a couple Brits before.
Yes, we've had our mayor come last year.
Oh, fantastic.
Yeah. So it's been kind of awesome to see who comes to the games. And we want to thank our fire department, our local fire and department. They send people for our games in case we have injuries. And they are like champs. They sit here and watch really good basketball
yeah.
and deal with injuries that happen. Hopefully not too many.
Yeah, hasn't been a lot this year. There's Anmo.
Caleb at the top of the key. Ah. Uncle's chimed in. Yes. Welcome back, my friend in Trinidad and Tobago. That is Caleb's uncle. Thank you for putting in the chat. He is a dedicated uncle. As I have nieces and nephews, I don't know if I'd be that dedicated. I love them, but I don't know if I'd be that dedicated.
I know the Hendry's twins tuned in, their uncle and aunt tuned in from Alberta.
Yes.
To say hello.
Yes.
Say good luck. For three.
Not there. Let's see what's... You know, Bethlehem's really good at moving the ball around.
Yep. Like Bedford's had a lot of good passing movement, but Bethlehem, it seems like, has a little bit more on the handles.
Yeah. Foxtrot always calls it quick hands. So I learned that. I learned that.
Quick hands, quick feet.
Yeah, I did the quick feet, but quick hands.
Look at you go, long shot.
I know. Riveting morning television. It used to be cartoons when I was little at this age, but now we have basketball.
Makes you feel like an adult.
Yeah.
That is twin number one. That's Kiefer Hendry. 22 is Grayson.
Oh, Caleb.
See, dribbling in. Getting swarmed there.
Yeah, but clean pass out.
Yeah, no fouls called. Charles.
Charles. You know, that's a quick ball. Like, to pass the ball that fast. Lynn Sanity asked me yesterday, do you think the ball gets warm from being dribbled and the friction and the frequency?
I think it would be more so from the holding. I think just being in contact with, like, warm hands, yeah.
Yeah. So one of these games when I'm not up here, I'm going to go actually touch it after the game and see if it's warm. You know, we leave nothing untested.
Yeah, you're going to have to be quick after the game or else it's going to cool down again. Dover with almost an interception. He just knocks it off course.
And, you know, they're rebounding. They are relentless at rebounding.
Yeah. That's Joseph Shao fighting against the Hendrys there. Draws the foul against Kiefer.
All right, it is, if you're just tuning in, 21-0 for Bethlehem in the second quarter.
Shao's got one more, live off the bounce.
See, did it again.
Forget the cam.
For the first one.
Yep. There it is.
We're on it.
Nothing but net.
Nothing but net.
All right.
A swoosh.
That was a nice pass.
Oh,
there it is.
First, and it's a three.
Buzzinga and Malgill.
Oh, so happy and relieved for the boys. Now they're going to just take off.
With our unbiased commentary. Yes, they're going to take off.
Well,
with our completely neutral.
I am neutral. I want the best team to win. I just want our boys not to have it deflated.
Yes, lost. Close at the very least.
Like,
there it is.
Game for them.
There it is. Thank you, Kiefer.
We're good.
Following the action.
We got this. And to be fair, I always cheer for the underdog. So.
Well, that's us most years.
Yes.
There's Tombe.
Oh,
no, that's
rebound.
Asaze.
Good rebound, though, by Hendry.
Over smart to just call them both Hendry.
It is. You know, I could try and memorize their numbers, but.
Well, it's nice when Grayson wears his signature headband.
Yeah.
Because you just look for the headband.
Yeah, accessories are good.
Yep.
And sometimes their shoes. Just shy.
Yeah.
The shot clock got them.
Bedford's been taking longer possessions, I'm seeing.
Yeah.
We've had three shot clock buzzers go off. And then Bethlehem is taking 10 seconds.
That was a good shot by Bethlehem. All right, Caleb at the top of the three-point. What's he going to do with it? Oh.
Sends it to Kiefer.
Oh, nice. See, we just needed that first one.
Just that started by Anmal.
You know,
thank you.
Shake off the cobwebs. Get the sleep out of your eyes. It's a new day.
You're ready to play some basketball.
Yes.
Great rebound in there.
Oh, Caleb in. It looked beautiful.
Draws a foul.
Draws a foul.
Shooting two this time. I'm confident. I saw the two fingers go up.
Mm-hmm. Oh, let's do the camera.
A lot of subs coming in.
It's like a whole new
roster
from Bedford.
I see Luke Bennett, Armand Gill, Sam Basong for Bethlehem, and then Dakshpreet Singh.
And Joseph was taken off from Bethlehem.
There it is. Caleb Dover, 1-for-2. We got the next team here for their game. They're looking just
rough.
A little bit sleepy as well.
Yeah.
Rough is harsh, but
it's
fair.
It's what it is. We're not looking pretty either. It's a good thing we just do voices.
Yeah, we're underneath the cameras.
Caleb, again, trying to figure out placement. Oh.
There's
a missed pass, and we're going down to Bethlehem, and Frank was controlling it.
Out to Patia. And then picked up by Osaze.
Yeah.
And then Sam. And Sam puts it in.
Of course. Because that's what Sam does.
That's what he does, yeah.
Oh, we tried to do some fancy work. Oh, but not out. Yes!
Lefty layup.
Oh, interception followed by a layup. Well done.
Riveting.
Yes, I'm so proud of them. I'm proud of all the players.
With number 9, Luis Ablan, sending it out to Baysong.
Oh, just shy.
And Armand Gill is right there.
All right, what is Dax going to do with this? Number 3, bring it up.
Sends it to Luke.
Luke, seeing the floor. Oh, interception by number 6, which is Patilla, of course.
Can't quite get it. Caleb fighting hard for the rebounds.
Yeah. Yep, they're kicking it in.
Dax again.
Oh, it looked beautiful. However, it did not go in. But Frank was trying really hard.
Yeah, Mr. Obillo.
And I believe...
we're shooting two?
I don't... yes. I thought I saw 2 fingers go up.
It's hard to pay attention sometimes.
Well, I'm paying attention to so many things, like shoes and hair, too, you know.
It's true.
Like animal shoes?
Oh, have you seen Armand's gold?
Oh, no, those are, yeah, I was thinking Armand's. Do you know they're twins?
They're not identical twins.
To me, they are. I don't know why. All right.
Sam Baysong.
Sam, he's just there.
A lot of Bedford hands in the way.
But Turth rebounded.
Thank you, Patel. Double teamed.
Dax is bringing it up. Is he just going to go the whole way? No. Oh, Turth. Fouls involved.
And he steps up to the stripe. Osaze, they're getting a little explanation from the ref on why. I think he questioned it a little bit, but he's good now.
Yeah.
There it is.
All right.
Tayot Suka back. Maurice Aranda, one of their starters, coming back.
Oh, Turth's just shy.
That's okay. He knows his adjustments. He knows what he has to do now.
That's awesome.
There wow. He is.
All right. Throwing it in. I know Bedford's doing full court press at this point. They're on them.
It's been working for a lot of teams, putting that constant pressure on. It's tiring for both, but...
yeah, it does. You have to have a well-conditioned team to pull that move off.
If you believe that your team can outlast the other, and Faye obviously thinks he does.
Yeah.
Faye believes in his team.
Well, they work hard.
They do.
As I see in practice here and late at night, they're here. They were here over Christmas break.
Oh.
Yeah, like they don't stop.
No, I know. I've seen a couple of their workouts where they're just sprinting up and down stairs, and it's like... yeah. Sometimes I'm glad I didn't join basketball just for that. I love the game. Love watching it.
Oh, they're stacked. Luke tried. Oh, Turth has it.
Let's go, Turth.
Gil. Oh, didn't make the 3. But he still looks good in those gold shoes.
They are shiny.
They are. They're kind of like, I want a pair of those. All right, Bethlehem, top of the 3.
Tie to Sam. Sam Malone.
Oh, to number 8. That looked beautiful. Leanne Gonzalez did an amazing job of making that look really nice. And, of course, getting points.
That's true. Bedford now down by 20. 1-1-1 was left on the clock. Amon's in the corner.
Yeah, Dedak. Then we have, look at the speed of the passing. They
I didn't even see Armand get over there.
Is that Luke?
Luke Bennett.
Oh, just shy. Oh.
Tayotsuka.
Oh. This is fast.
That's what it's all about, isn't it?
That was a fast rundown.
Turth Patel.
Excuse me, sorry. All right, beautiful.
Fantastic there, Zamran.
All right, top of key, number 8 to number 12. Down to 10. And, of course, to Sam. Oh, Reed.
Aranda can jump. Holy. He's 5'6", and he got that rebound like it was nothing.
Yep.
There is Gonzalez. Sam Baysong. that dominant force that he is.
So close. Oh, they had four Bedford players on him.
Gonzalez to Aranda. There's Osaze.
Oh. They tried hard. They tried hard. As they're going into halftime.
All right. Bethlehem Stars leading the home team, Bedford Red Hawks, 30-12. We'll see you in a little bit. We've got a 10-minute break here. Sweet Defeat and Long Shot set it off for just a tad.
Thank you.
welcome back to the second half. We have already on the court. Bethlehem has taken the court. And Bedford is getting its last pointers of how to come back and win this game.
From coach's little team cheer.
Oh, it was serious. Faye had his whiteboard.
Oh.
You know, when teachers bring out whiteboards, that means business.
It's business.
It's business.
There it is.
All right.
Ooh. I believe that's the first time we've seen number 11, Ghazan Khan.
Oh. Oh, yeah.
Here he comes. Let's see if that was the right move by Faye. I think so.
I think so. All right. Bethlehem first ones to score.
Osaze Ozegal.
That means nothing. That means nothing. Both teams are still in this. All right. Oh, overshot. Oh, look at that. Frank was fast. He has fast feet.
Maurice Aranda.
Number two?
Yes.
Oh, I thought it was number three.
You're doing great.
Thanks. I don't teach math. Numbers aren't math.
I don't think reading numbers counts as math.
You know, I remember my parents saying I was an excellent student, but, you know.
Oddly enough, my parents have never said that about me.
It helped. My dad was one of my teachers. Oh. I was a good student because he was one of my teachers.
Yeah, you can't go home and talk about how bad your teacher is when that's happening. Bedford again taking a full 24-second possession. Here's Obillo. And Bethlehem has had a tendency to get quick drives.
Yeah.
He looked for the corner.
It's not the first time these two teams have played against each other. They play against in our city league.
Yes.
And so they're not new to each other, but it's just working out the kinks today that seems to be a problem.
Coach Feather did kick the ball before the whistle was actually blown, but it did go out of bounds, so that was the right move by him.
He likes to get involved.
He does.
He's a real hands-on coach, which is good.
I think if he shaved a little bit and put on, some casual clothes, he might be able to play as a student.
You know, he'd have to play on a different team, because we all know him, but yeah.
That's true.
He could.
See if he can sneak onto the Raymond comments. He looks a lot like a lot of them, actually.
Yeah. Yes.
Just the facial structure and everything.
Oh, I like it when it lets
all
you sit there.
All around the world. You know it's in, but you just have to watch.
Yeah. And it slows the game down, I think,
yes.
A little bit.
Gives them some time.
Oh. All right. Dak's taking it up the court, his colorful shoes.
Set up to Jet under double pressure. Out to Daksh. And around to G. Guillermo. Helping Bedford claw back a little closer game here. 6 minutes left. No look pass. Based on. What a jumper.
Oh my goodness. That was beautiful.
That was art in motion. Aranda picks it up, sends it to Patia. Who puts it in for an easy two.
And it looked effortless.
It did.
Wow. Jet with the basket, which is awesome.
There we go. One of the changes here I'm noticing.
Oh, that was nice.
Double ball pressure by Bedford Road. They're almost always putting two guys at least on whoever is holding the ball. I saw it with Sam there. Sam a lot. Just because he drives the way he does.
Well, you got to key on some players that you know are going to be your biggest trouble.
And speaking of.
Yeah, if you can. Oh, that was.
Goodness gracious.
Went for a dunk, missed it. However, good for Bedford, I guess.
He missed that?
Did he? Or
did I totally thought that went in.
Okay, he might have.
Totally. Where's the replay? Do we have a replay on
we
here?
We don't have
on
a replay.
On the. Any fans at home, can you just let us know?
He probably made it. I blinked, so he probably made it. All right, we got Ghazan at the top. Over G. He's just circles.
He drives.
Pass it out to Dak. And for the three, came up short and then rebounded by Patia. Again, Sam.
There is. That's Shao, Joseph Shao.
I noticed that the Bethlehem players, when they pass with intent. Like, they know exactly where it's going, and they have the muscle to get it there in a quick rate. Oh, we're having full
team substitution
for Bedford. All right, we got Zamrin.
We've got 3 out of 4 twins. And then Charles Puche and Zamrin Faze.
Nice. Oh, Charles cutting in.
And Maul.
Didn't make the three, but it was rebounded.
By none other than Sam Baesong?
Yeah.
Yeah. I mean, it's hard not to with Sam. He has a 6'3 frame, grade 12. He knows how to play this game.
And he's determined.
And he's very determined.
I like it when the refs and players can have a good discussion
over what happened.
It doesn't get heated. Out of hand. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Same with coaches as well. I love seeing the coaches get energized about calls.
Yeah.
Last year we did have a technical call on one of the coaches there. Just because of how much they were having some trouble with the calls.
Very exuberant. But it is nice to see respect in the sport.
Yes.
And our fan base was really good both days. Oh, Sam? No. Is that Sam again?
Yes.
Yes, it was, of course.
Foul on number 22, versus Henry, number 11, Sam Solomon.
All right.
Smooth
well
like butter.
Done. Oh, you guys, one more?
Here he comes. Is that Petit Tombe I see? Out to Sam. I don't even know what to say about Sam. He's a phenomenal player.
He is.
He's consistent from the free throw, consistent in drives, and as we're seeing now, consistent on the threes. Charles.
All over Charles for the three. Didn't make it, but he tried really hard. All right.
That's number 5 there, Juma Jokino. Haven't seen too much of him this game. He's looking to make some impressions.
All right.
Is that Yahi Yahi I see out there?
Oh.
Yahi Yahi, number 15. One of my favorite names in perhaps the whole tournament.
Charles from 3. Animals open.
So is Armand.
Unfortunately, it was an air ball. But Animals running his little butt down to the other end.
Do you know which twin is older in both sets?
We did have that discussion one day in class, and I do not remember the outcome.
Totally forgot. It's okay. I wouldn't listen to Armand either.
I think Armand is the oldest. He said he gets to boss Anmol around. It could just be their relationship.
Yeah, that might just be Anmol not wanting to be a little bit of a dink to his brother there.
Hendry up for 2.
And Hendry brings it down. There he is. Bedford here down by 23. Charles knocks it out. But no shot clock reset, so this is good.
Coaches are chiming in with their thoughts on the play.
That's how it is sometimes. You don't want to call time out.
You can just yell.
You just
yell.
I did
it all the time.
It's efficient. It works. There's Yahi Yahi out to number 5, Juma.
Look at them move the ball around. So, they're counting down. They're going to beat. No, they did not beat. Bedford did a good job of keeping them out of shot range.
There we go, Juma.
But we got a foul now. All right. First shot.
And
He made that look easy.
Yeah, he did.
No, I like watching NBA games when people can't hit the shot.
Right? A professional, and it's like, you get paid
millions
of dollars to do this thing.
And they get, like, sponsorship shoes.
Yeah.
Like, they get everything, and that's this, it's like a kicker for a football team. It's like,
yeah. One and only job.
Yeah. Make sure it's good. Nice work.
There he is. Go, that's Zam. Out to Anmal.
Nice. For the three. Third quarter, we have just around 90 seconds left in it.
Bedford down by 22. Gonna need to make some big changes here in the fourth quarter. Good pickup by Armand.
Yeah. He is not letting anything go.
No. Compared to the 6'2", Joseph Shao, Armand Gill here, 5'11". And he's pushing. Mm-hmm. Here comes Zam. Zam, a multi-sport athlete, as are most of these boys.
Oh, travel called on Charles.
Here comes Juma Jaquino. Nice fake there. Up to Jed. Yahi. That's good movement.
They're just keeping that ball going, which means our players are not scrambling, but they're running.
Yeah.
They're controlled.
Foul called again. Jed Carbonell steps up. We've got a full five lineup for Bedford coming on. Gazan, Luke, Kiefer. Is that Kiefer? That's Kiefer, Jet, and Caleb step on. Full substitution.
And Luke?
Yes, Luke Bennett. Younger brother of a former Bedford starter as well, so it really runs in the family.
Well, Bedford is a small enough school that we have family ties.
Yeah.
To so many students, or siblings here and cousins here, and so it's great to see.
For sure it is.
Families carry on in the tradition. Up to the top of the three-point line. Bedford's
they're sending
well.
Them all around.
But Bedford rebounded. Hendriot taking it down. What is he going to do? Over to Luke. Caleb. Go, Caleb.
Right-handed drive. There's Josh Paris there fighting against him.
It's a fight. Both of them not giving up. It clean, no foul. That's impressive for Caleb. Hendry has it.
Oh, 10 seconds.
I just looked at our chat. The dunk did go in. I totally messed that one up. Sorry, people.
Thank you, Mr. Sweet there.
Yes. I'm glad.
All right, here comes 10 seconds left.
Right,
gonna
Bedford.
Have to do something quick. One more quarter to go. Leading by 22, though. We're moving it. And then 1.2 seconds. Not a lot of time. I'm calling Paris is going to shoot out to the left. Nope.
We end the third quarter. Sorry. And yes, Bedford is trailing Bethlehem. It is 45-23. But we've made it a long distance. We never count out any team, so that's exciting.
Exactly right. That's what basketball is. That's what Brit is. Always fighting. Just because you're down 22 does not mean that you're down out of the game.
No.
You got to push just as hard as if you're up by 10.
Yeah, you can't get lazy.
No, you never can.
Nope. I notice one of our teachers, Mr. Waldron, is taping up another player from another team. I think that is good sportsmanship when you can help out, you know, teams if you have the skills.
Exactly.
More of our sponsors that we need to thank are Oh, I'm looking at the sign. My brain is not clicking in, though. It's Laser Auto yes. Body. This is the season for a lot of car accidents in Saskatoon. I have seen, thankfully not been involved in any accidents in winter. So that's good. But the only accident we had was we hit a moose with our vehicle.
When?
In July.
Oh.
Yeah. The moose is no joke.
No.
No.
No, you lose to a moose.
Yeah. And we hit a yearling moose, so we weren't dead. But they did come through the windshield, so.
Scary. Medicine Rope Strategies, another sponsor the book.
All right, top of the key three. Oh, my word. Way to go, Kazam.
Here he comes. Good fingers there by Jet. And then Hendry picks it up. I almost.
Is that Luke?
Yeah, Luke Bennett, yes.
Luke
yes,
got
it
shut
is.
Shut down, but. All right, let's see what they do with this.
Download to Jet.
Jet was double teamed there by 8 and 10. All right.
Going for the same play. Oh, running a stack right now.
Yeah, they're doing the stack. And Hendry was right there. Unfortunately, it didn't go.
Here comes Osaze. Osaze sizzling through.
Yeah. Man, he's quick. Oh, incomplete pass.
Here comes Beth. One of the troubles of these early morning games is the fans haven't really all got here yet. If you come in Saturday night, we have people literally crowding the entrance because there are no more seats. We have to Brit shuffle. Everyone is squished in. You are meeting your neighbors, whether you want to or not.
Yeah. And last year, there were so many people that they had to stop entrance. We were over fire code, and the fire people are here. So we couldn't break it.
I mean...
That, which is good. You know, laws are put in place for safety, and that's good. But we definitely need to
pay attention to that.
Do the Brit shuffle. You got to just get by the neighbor.
There is Patia up to Lewis Abland. Picked up by Caleb.
Caleb wrote. Caleb's having trouble. Four-court press, and... hard to maneuver.
Andrew Kiefer, thank you.
All right, they're working into the key. Rebounded by 10.
Osaze. Patia. Obillo.
Oh, and it's a nicely done.
Mr. Ozagal.
Yeah. He has a sweet name, too.
Yeah, well, speaking of sweet names, sweet defeat.
Oh. You're so funny.
He was right there. I had to.
All right, Caleb. Maneuvering the ball to Jet, to Hendry. And it's good.
Ball is through.
Oh, goodness.
They got to pay attention, though. Beth is already driving. Already attacking. They got to get in their formation. Otherwise, Osaze called on a travel there. What does Osaze have right by his knees there? I'm looking. I think I might have seen it earlier today. And I thought it was some kind of knee brace or something like that. But I don't know.
I've seen them on players.
Yeah, I've seen
exactly
it on a couple other players.
I don't know if they're just a streamlined support. And I'm old, so it could be something cool. Oh, drained by Gil.
Yeah, that's something cool.
Oh,
there it is.
That's awesome. Well done. Mr. Faye came alive, and so did their bench. Oh.
Bedford here starting to come back. 16 points. Is it too little, too late?
No. You never give
no.
up.
No. All
never
right.
Give up.
You heard it here. Long shot calling it. No, it is not too late.
No. Nope. You fight till the end.
Osaze.
Hendriana, and so was Gil, literally.
Yeah. With that good pressure there, getting close to the key. I want to stop easy layups, stop anything like that.
I like looking at our boys so concentrated and like they're in this and they're not giving up.
Isn't that what they look like in class as well?
No.
Focused and paying attention?
Oh, no. Completely different personas.
Yeah, there's something about the adrenaline and everything.
And I think they enjoy basketball.
I can imagine.
Just throwing that out there. All right, we have a timeout called.
That's by Coach Faye there, calling a timeout to talk to his peeps.
We have Ham Construction, Old Dutch Chips, Rock Creek, and Flavors Catering. If you have an event, do you have events that get catered?
Brit, I wish. They had us volunteers all set up with a nice buffet spread to give us something.
I like flavor. It's good. And Huskies, of course.
Power of the pack.
One of our coaches for the girls is actually a coach for Huskies. And so the Huskies are playing right now in a tournament out of province. And she's here dedicated to Brit.
Oh, wow.
Yeah.
It
is pretty awesome that has happened.
That much dedication. Yeah.
Yeah.
Terrific to see.
Yeah.
Which coach is that? Do you know?
Miss Humbert.
Yes.
Yes. All right.
Miss Humbert coaches volleyball, yes?
Yes.
Not the basketball
not
team?
Basketball,
okay. No, okay.
She coaches volleyball for Huskies and our girls. She does so much for
Miss Humbert is fantastic.
Yeah, she got the gym athletics at noon all organized, and she has a Be Fit club that is quite large.
Yeah, the Be Active, Girls Be Active.
It is. She is awesome. She's just a spark in our building.
That's true. The Humbert line has always had a chance. You can see Davis Humbert there, coaches the Aiden Bowman team.
Yes. Their sports family, that's her brother, and definitely her educators as well.
Yep, teachers.
All right, we have Zamarin.
Shoots it out to G.
No, we might have to, I don't know where our cameraman went, we might have to do this so you can see what's happening. All right, we're gonna hang out at the keep.
Good timing. Our cameraman's just getting up, but
we're
taking
right
freeze
spot.
Anyways.
Nice.
One. Uno. Can he get dos?
Whoa. Are you bilingual?
Close enough, I think. Got uno dos. Get to trace. There's dos. Here they come.
Right.
Bedford keeping their dribble strong.
Oh no, interception.
Aranda. There's Ty.
Oh.
Just the reach of Osaze.
You know, he's just everywhere.
He is. He plays fast. And the fact that he has that great wingspan. You saw him reach out, just curl the ball into himself, and then puts it up.
Like the control he has and the intellectual.
Precision.
Well, and it's intellectual. So
yes,
you
gotta it is.
Read the situation well. And make choices based on that.
It's tough with basketball. Situational awareness, positional awareness.
Yeah. You got coaches yelling at you, you're trying to listen to as well.
And then you're trying to dribble.
Yes. And not foul someone.
Yes.
In all of the chaos.
One of the hardest parts of that, because fouls are a crucial part of this game.
Yeah. Oh, we're doing full bench
full
switch
as well.
Again.
I almost wish Mr. Faye would keep both the twins on, just for the mental block of seeing the man you're guarding. You pass him, and there he is
again.
Right there in front of you, staring you dead in the eyes.
All right, Dax shaking it up. Charles, Pouche.
Out to Luke.
Pucci. They're counting them down. We need a shot. Luke Bennett with the shot. Unfortunately, rebounded by Hendry, though.
Yeah, off the rim, so they get a full reset.
You know, it's 35-53, and we have just under 3 minutes left.
Reverse palindrome. Good push there by Dax.
Good catch on the palindrome. Nice work.
I try. I learned something from school, believe it or not.
All right, Charles again.
Great grab there.
Yeah.
Quick toss off to Luke. Charles Pucci is left alone at the top.
Just off. Dax took the three, but wasn't there. Bethlehem getting taken up by Leanne Gonzalez. And of course it ends up
in the hands of Osaze Ozegal.
Yeah. We all know the ending of this, but.
Yeah, 2 minutes here for Bedford to make quite a comeback. And Osaze is playing like he's fresh.
Yes.
20-point game now.
Yeah. Charles. Oh.
Good grab there by Dax Preet.
Yeah. Hendry
to Dax.
Dax for the three. Dax. Nah, didn't make it. Unfortunately.
Shao.
Oh, we're down to number 12.
Ty. I know his name is Ty. Otsuka. There it is. Ozegal drives and then kicks it out.
Oh, determination. You know, like volleyball players dive
yes,
all the time. And
but
that's part
they're
of their
trained
job.
Too, yeah.
Yeah, and they're just.
These guys
their
are
bodies.
Literally just. Chucking themselves. That's what's great about high school because they can do that. If you tried that, how long has it taken you to get back up after you throw yourself to the floor?
Well, one, I would make the choice not to throw myself to the floor.
There's that situational awareness.
Yeah, and I would just be like, you know, it's out. So
it's too late.
Yeah.
Yeah, last Brit, someone actually smashed into that, broke one of the panels on the Brit board.
Yeah. Forgot about
fully
that.
Fully took it out of the frame. Guess who got to fix that, fans? Just over 1 minute left to score 20 points. No, Yahi.
Oh. Oh, we got Kazan in. Taking Dax out.
And Jet.
Up. Oh, they took Jet out too? Or Jet came in?
Jet's right there.
Oh, he's shooting.
He's shooting.
Well done. Done.
Here he comes.
Nice.
Jet gets nothing but net. You'll see him often in lunch hours just practicing, so it's good to see that hard work does pay off.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure all the young men in front of us are in the gym all the time practicing.
Hard practicing.
Yeah.
Okay. Except the ones who are studying. And that would be they're not here right now. I know there's one.
There's gotta be.
There he is.
All right, top of the three. You know, as they're reading the situation, Bedford is standing tall.
Yeah, no.
It's hard to shoot over their hands up in the air.
Yeah, they do have a taller team compared to us. 6'3", 6'1", 6'4". Bedford Road's tallest player stands 6'2", and that's Grayson Hendry and Jet Sampson.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm so sorry, Kiefer Hendry, being a sibling and getting 1 inch taken off your height.
Mm. I wonder who measured. All right, three-pointer shot and not happen.
Apple
we have
15
seconds left. And the winner of this game will be declared as Bethlehem.
Charles Pucci makes a shot. Is Yahi Yahi.
Oh, he's going to end on a good note?
Nope. Oh. Out of bounds before the buzzer, but Coach Faye just makes a little signal to the refs that they don't need that extra 0.6 seconds.
No. I don't think they could come back by that much at that point.
Physically impossible.
All right, so this is the end of the road for Bedford Road. They don't have any more games
I don't
now.
Believe so.
No, they're done.
They're done. And every team is guaranteed 3 games, and Bedford took our three.
We took our three, which means that the winner of this plays where's that bracket?
Do, 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 do.
At 7:30. Nope.
this might be the end. I don't know. They might be done because it's heading off to the side. I'm not sure.
All right. Oh, we're doing an awards presentation. Let's listen to them.